just hit the 51st parallel. And we're climbing. It's 300 kilometers to Fairmount. And then onwards to Labrador City. And you get these traffic lights out in the middle of nowhere. They're repairing the roads here, and I have to say that this is probably one of the best dirt roads that I've come across. I mean, this thing runs for close to 300-400 kilometers from Manic 5 all the way up to Labrador City, and you get these repairs being done every so often, like every 50 clicks or something. And you know, I guess they're prepping themselves for the winter, because the truckers use this road. Like, I mean, you'll see a truck passing every 15-20 minutes on this road. But yeah, they're very well maintained. I mean, you could do 70, 80 clicks on this road, no sweat. Although I try to keep down the speed limit, because I don't know if you can hear it, but my muffler is gone. I had the straight pipe repaired about 3 months ago, and now the other section in the back where the muffler is attached to the straight pipe, came loose, and I don't want to lose it before I get back to Montreal, because I don't know how much it would cost me to get this thing repaired up here in Labrador. It'd probably cost me a fortune. Anyway, I'll catch you guys a little later. Gotta tell you guys, the last 50, 60 kilometers of dirt road to get into Fairmount and then to Labrador, it's been horrible, disgusting. Man, I'm gonna need a new car when I get back. I'm telling you, I'm contemplating if I should come back the same way or should just loop it the other way. Horrible, man, I tell you. Guys, there ain't gonna be no fancy camps or campfires. Just headed back from Labrador City, and tonight's gonna be the old-fashioned way, the cot next to the car. See, the road is here, and there's a slight curve up on top there, and there's another one here. So I imagine if the trucks are coming down or the cars, they're not going to be bombing. And I also put my car on that side there to protect me against the morons that drive like crazy. I can assure you one thing though, bugs are out, and they're out with a vengeance tonight. They're all over the place. See, that's why I never leave home without my bug net. They are out tonight, guys. Oh my God. If I didn't have this thing, there's no way I'd be able to sleep outside on the cot. And I'm telling you, black flies are out. Oh my Lord. I just hope that when it gets a little colder tonight. Let me go back to sleep. I really don't feel like looking for firewood. Besides, I'm going to be leaving very early in the morning, like, I don't know, probably around 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm out of here. So I'm only going to need a couple of hours rest. I didn't feel like staying in Labrador City. I went to this little restaurant there and I had what they call tacos. And boy, oh boy. I don't know, man. I think I'll be okay. But, you know, brought the bug net, but I didn't bring the Imodium. Maybe I'll spend the night there at the hotel. Charge the batteries too. But I realized that I had an extra battery for my cam and my GoPro. Apparently, I can charge it with the cigarette lighter. I just use a little thingy-majingy there that you put a USB and then you put it into your lighter of the car. And I just put it into the GoPro and wham, it worked. It took about an hour and a half, but it charged. So we'll be okay, guys. Anyway, if there's anything interesting that comes around, I'll let you guys know. We'll see. We might hear wolves tonight. The lake is on the other side over there. Lake is over there. The road goes down this way. And it continues and then it turns off that way. So we're pretty much secluded up here. You know, I could have gone into the woods, but nah, I'm just too tired, man. I'm really tired. I said I'm gonna take this long drive up and see what gives. I did it, and I wish I hadn't. But anyway, we live and we learn, guys. See you later. That tailpipe is making a lot of noise. Hope I make it back to Montreal. We're gonna head back now to Manic 5 and proceed on to Lake Louise. Maybe spend the night there. We shall see. Just noted something up on the left side. I noticed it a while back. My eyes aren't that good. I'm just wondering what the hell that is. Is it a road sign or is it a little moose or something? other guy's under the truck there. Yeah, here in Manicsank, I just came across Julie and her team of dogs. She has her African hounds, and she races them part-time, like as a hobby. And she allowed us to take pictures. She goes, sometimes she takes people out, sometimes she doesn't. She doesn't do it for a living. Julie Rabitaille. See? Good people up here. South on the 389, started our journey back home. So what time is it now? It's like 6:40 p.m. and sun's coming down pretty quickly. Actually, I don't want to drive on this route at night in the dark. I get night blindness sometimes, you know, when I'm driving the car. So, and it's a two-way highway, and there's a lot of trucks coming on the opposite direction, and they're coming like full blast, these guys. So the next nice little spot that I see an opening on the side of the road, we're gonna pull over, we're gonna prepare our cot, probably do a diamond configuration, or actually a plow point configuration with our C-line cart, and spend the night. And in the morning we'll have some breakfast and then head back out. It's pretty interesting, it was fun. Got away for a few days, you know. Nice and quiet, all by my lonesome, you know. I think we're coming up to a nice little spot here. Let's see what gives here. Okay. What do we have here? We have somewhere we can... let me take a look over here. Well, I'm going to go out and check the place out. I don't want to have any encounters with bears or anything. No, there are bears out here, and I'm really not in the mood, you know. Usually come out of the forest and into these openings because of the people's garbage that they just throw all over the place. So I'm just gonna go out and check this place out.
Fresh bear scat, my friend. Something scared it. It was taking a dump and continued to dump, working its way into the forest here. More shit here. Maybe you heard the car. He took off. Just missed him. Crap. Better luck next time.
There were some moose tracks on the right side, right behind those bushes there. You can't see it. I'm not gonna sit around here. There's a moose going by here. No siree, Bob. I'm not so worried about the bears. Moose, you know, better safe than sorry. We'll check out the next spot. Oh, you're coming around these places and you wanna stay in your car and sleep in the car, you're cool, it's okay, man, you're protected. But you know, when you're out on your own and moose decides to come out, and if you know, I mean, it's not the rut season now, but nevertheless, these guys can be vicious, you know, like vicious, you know. But a moose will not back down, you know what I'm saying? A bear, hit against the pot and pan, chances are he's gonna take off. But moose, I don't know, I wouldn't chance it. Anyway, I'm gonna drive down for another few kilometers and see if we can come up to another opening. We'll get back to you guys a little later so I can conserve some of my battery life, because I'm not going to have anywhere to charge it before I get to Baie-Comeau. I'll see you guys in a while. Just arrived in Baie-Comeau and we're passing through. Heading home, guys, heading home. This phone hasn't stopped whistling at me. We've had a lot of action while I was away. I can't wait to get back home and check all the emails and the how the site's doing. Anyway, this is beautiful Baie-Comeau, my friends. We just left Quebec City. I was gonna spend the night in the Saguenay region, but I missed the exit for that rest area, and then I was just too wound up, and I couldn't try to stop. You know, I did off the side of the road there, but I just couldn't. Stay the night. Anyway, we're about an hour and a half away from home, and in case some of you guys wonder, the lights that I have on this vehicle, how they help, well, what I'm driving with right now is simply my headlights, and this is what happens when I turn on the Hellas. Get a load of this, guys. So as you can see, it makes a huge difference. And then when I put my fogs, I see the side of the road. I can see the white line in the middle, and the white checkered line in the middle, and the solid line in the on the right. And when it's very foggy, these lights here, the fogs, that's what they help you do. A lot of people don't know what it's about. Fog stays above your wheel level. So what you need light
below that level there, so you can get, so you can see the line. So actually you don't see what's in front of you, but at least you can keep your car within the two lines between the broken line and the solid line, so you don't go off the road. If you reduce your speed enough, like not to a stop, but you know, to a limit where you know you're at least 10 car lengths behind somebody, it will give you enough time to stop. So what these fogs are doing, they're just illuminating the lines on the bottom of the on the road. They're not made for you to see in a distance. Anyway, I hope that was a little bit helpful. And now that we're gonna pass these set of lights, that these street lights here, and I'll show you something else. Okay, so I'm turning off the fogs. You'll notice, take a look at the lines on the road. See the lines on the side? You don't see them anymore. Well, let me take off the helles, the beams. Okay. Now, I'm going to turn on the fogs, and you're going to see what I'm talking about. Check this out. See? You can see the lines. Even if I turn off my lights, just driving with the fogs now, and you can see the lines. Projectors. Headlamps. Those are the two helles that I have in my front grill. You notice on the top of the car, they're floodlights. They don't do much, really. It's got to be super dark. Check it out. See? It doesn't illuminate much. Like, let me turn off. See? See, I'm driving with the floodlights. Get back home and stick all these little SD cards in the computer and edit. It's gonna take some time. I think I'm gonna do like four little videos. I don't want to do a whole, maybe 1 hour video of the whole adventure that we took together. It's gonna be too long. I don't want people to get bored, so I'm either gonna do it in part 1, 2, and 3, or I'm gonna break it up. Anyway, it was a lot of fun. Met some people, you know. I met Bernard from Air Safari Labrador. He goes back many, many years, and my friend Clement still has his outfitting camp up in Matanipi. Who knows? Might just bring myself around to go visit these guys. Actually, I'm going to be calling Bernard from Air Safari. See, maybe I can work something out with him. Pay Clement a surprise visit after 25 years. That would be something. I'll catch you guys a little later, or probably when the editing is all done. Speak to you guys later. Ciao.